In the previous exercises, we found the derivative, the rate of change at a particular point. However, we may also have circumstances in which we want the derivative at several different values. When that happens, we can find the formula for the derivative, that is, get a derivative function first. The formula for the derivative function, that's f prime of x, is equal to the limit as h approaches 0 of f of x plus h minus f of x all divided by h. The only difference is where we had a previously, we now have x. The example, find the derivative f prime if f of x equals the square root of x plus 4. We need to find the derivative f prime of x. We'll use that derivative formula. It's also called the definition of the derivative. And we'll write the limit as h approaches 0 of, and for the function square root of x plus 4, where we have f of x plus h, we'll replace the x with x plus h. We still have the plus 4 minus f of x is just our function, which would be the square root of x plus 4, and this will be divided by h. The algebra for simplifying this type of expression involves using what is called the conjugate. The conjugate is when you take the expression, for example, if you have the square root of x plus h plus 4, and you also have the square root of x plus 4, where the minus was, we write plus. We'll multiply the numerator and the denominator with the square root of x plus h plus 4 plus the square root of x plus 4. Like the difference of squares, the product of the inside terms and the product of the outside terms cancel out. So this becomes the limit as h approaches 0 of, let's do the denominator first, it's easier. It'll be h times the square root of x plus h plus 4 plus the square root of x plus 4. To multiply those two terms in the numerator, you might even want to think of the FOIL. Multiply the first terms together, the square root of x plus h plus 4 times the square root of x plus h plus 4. That will just be x plus h plus 4. The outside terms product and the inside terms product cancel out, and the product of the last terms, that's the square root of x plus 4 times the square root of x plus 4, is x plus 4. Let's perform the subtraction. You have an x minus x, 4 minus 4. This becomes the limit as h approaches 0 of, the only term remaining in the numerator is h, and in the denominator we still have the same thing, h times the square root of x plus h plus 4 plus the square root of x plus 4. The h in the numerator and the h in the denominator cancel. That's a good thing. The goal here is we want to get rid of that h in the denominator so that we're not trying to divide by 0. This becomes the limit as h approaches 0 of, 1 is all in the numerator, and the denominator is the square root of x plus h plus 4 plus the square root of x plus 4. We can now do direct substitution, meaning put in 0 for the h. So you'll have 1 divided by the square root of x plus 0 plus 4 plus the square root of x plus 4. And that takes us to the derivative f prime of x is equal to 1 divided by, you've got 2 square roots of x plus 4. Example, suppose f of x equals x cubed. Find f prime of x. That means find the derivative. So we're going to use the derivative formula. F prime of x is equal to the limit as h approaches 0 of f of x plus h minus f of x divided by h. Let's write this out. F prime of x is equal to the limit as h approaches 0 of f of x plus h. We're going to put in x plus h every place there is an x, cubed minus f of x, which is x cubed, divided by h. Just as a quick aside, x plus h cubed means x plus h times x plus h times x plus h. It is not x cubed plus h cubed. This is equal to the limit as h approaches 0 of x plus h cubed is x cubed plus 3 x squared h plus 3 x h squared plus h cubed, and don't forget the minus x cubed, which is the minus f of x, divided by h. In the numerator, the x cubes subtract out. This becomes the limit as h goes to 0 of 3 x squared h plus 3 x h squared plus h cubed divided by h. Remember, our goal here is to figure out a way to factor out the h in the denominator. We see that there is a common h through the numerator, so we can write this as the limit as h approaches 0 of factoring out an h. You have 3x squared plus 3xh plus h squared divided by h. That lets us cancel that h out of the denominator, which takes us to the derivative function f prime of x is the limit as h approaches 0 of 3x squared plus 3 times xh plus h squared. We can do the direct substitution, that is put in 0 every place there is an h, and you end up with 3x squared. The derivative of x cubed is 3x squared. Now that we know how to find the derivative, let's see what the relationship is between the graphs of the function and the graph of the derivative. Example, consider the graph of f shown below. Use the graph to obtain characteristic information about the graph of f prime, the derivative, and then sketch the graph of the derivative. To do this, we're going to make a sign chart number line of the derivative function. We draw a number line, and let's make some observations. For this graph, we have a horizontal tangent line where x equals negative 1. And so when x equals negative 1, the derivative function, which is the slope of the tangent line, is going to be 0. Remember, horizontal line, slope is 0. The other point of significance occurs when x equals 1, because again, a tangent line drawn to the curve at x equals 1 is horizontal, and the slope of a horizontal line is 0. Now let's determine the signs of the derivative. We know that if we are to draw any tangent lines from negative infinity all the way to x equals negative 1, the function is rising, so any tangent line on a curve where it's rising, the slope would be positive. The slope is positive, then the derivative is positive. That happens from negative infinity to negative 1. It happens again from x equals 1, where the graph rises from 1 to positive infinity, and the slope of any tangent line drawn to a curve in that region would be positive. If the slope is positive, then the derivative is positive. Now, in the interval between x equals negative 1 and positive 1, the function is falling. If you were to draw a tangent line on any part of the curve, it would be a falling tangent line, which means that the slope would be less than 0 or negative. If the slope of the tangent line is negative, then the derivative is negative. The sign chart tells us that the derivative f prime is positive on two different intervals, from negative infinity to negative 1, and also from 1 to positive infinity. We see from the sign chart that the derivative is negative between negative 1 and 1. We will use this information to get a graph of the derivative. A function value is positive means it is above the x-axis. So from negative infinity to negative 1, and again from positive 1 to infinity, the derivative is above the x-axis. Between negative 1 and positive 1, the derivative is negative. If a function is negative, then it is below the x-axis. That should look a little bit more like a parabola. Of course, the other thing that I'd like for you to take note of is where there is a horizontal tangent line to the graph, the derivative is 0. That happens at negative 1 and again at 1.